second grade in Penguin District School. And these are my three animals. I have one more, a cat. My rats passed away a few months ago. Mum was called Nibbles. She had red eyes and white fur. I thought that I had a lot of love left in my heart for other animals, so I thought that instead of getting more animals, we could just go to people's houses and look after their animals, so that's how I started my business. My business is called...
The Tug and Yacht Ballet, ladies and gentlemen.
Sunset takes my mind back to my homeland far away. It's a story planted in my mind. It's so clear. I remember my sunset dreaming.
Australia Day celebrations. Our First Nations people are the traditional custodians of our beautiful lands and waterways, where they have a fundamental role in the great Australian story, one which we continue to reflect, respect and celebrate together. Imparting and sharing knowledge passed down from many, many generations past is what has helped preserve the world's oldest living culture. And for Matt Sims, doing that is a deeply spiritual and emotional practice.
Australia to me is ancient. It's a really, really old place. And my people have been here since the first sunrise. Jiriba, Wagara. Jiriba is two, and Wagara is crows. We deliver cultural programs from Sydney to Eden. Tourism for me, I think it's really, really special because I'm able to share stuff that I've learned along my journey and share this beautiful place here. We share with everyone because we want people to see what we see when we're in the bush, you know, looking through the cultural lens. So you see what I see. In turn, you can take care of the earth like I've been taught. You know, that's what it's about. It's about that transfer of knowledge and sharing. The first couple of walks that I ran, I saw how connected people became. It just lit a fire within inside me, knowing that I need to do this. You know, I knew straight away, because I saw people get that emotion.
But at the same time, I want to embrace the Aussie life.
I'm from the States originally. Now I'm the program director at the Fred Hollows Foundation. My first visit to Australia was actually for the interview.
From the moment that I came to Australia, I was welcome. Celebrating the many diverse voices that make up our great country is what our National Day is all about. It's now time to introduce another uniquely Australian voice. Leaving opera and poetry behind us, let's really turn this party up a notch with some rock and roll. Please welcome the one and only, it's Mr. John Stevens. Thank you.
Give it to me straight, face to face. Are you really disappearing? Just another
dying race. But she has full hair, Miss Ben.
My name is Wally Wales. I've lived around Dungarry for 68 years.
That's a
good one. And I'm volunteering for the post office. I'm 75, Les is 81. Carol, being a lady, won't tell us her age. We're all retirement age, but we don't want to sit at home and do nothing. We want to do something. That's basically the way everyone is around here. We're all getting older. We look after one another and we live a very quiet life.
What language do you use?
Why the post office closed, Jeffrey DeRosio, our postmaster, had died during the night. Jeffrey was one of life's total gentlemen. When he delivered mail, he knocked on doors to ensure that someone was inside the house capable of walking. Lots of us.
From the mountain to the valley, from the ocean to the bay.
beautiful, beautiful. Nessun Dorma is an Australian Day tradition here at the Opera House that is always so moving and so beautiful, which can also be said for poetry, using our uniquely Australian voices in so many ways.
Thank you.
entertainers. Also, a huge thanks to the legendary Mr. John Stevens and the one and only Andrew Farris from INXS, plus the fabulous Buck Sydney Philharmonic Choir and the Aussie Pops Orchestra, who are phenomenal.
Oh, thank you. Yes, also we have to thank our magnificent and multi-talented co-hosts, Delta Goodrum, Casey Donovan and Jeremy Fernandez, whose jacket looks even better up close and in person. We hope that we have shared some optimism with you tonight for 2022 and shed a light on just some of the people that helped make up one extra firework. That's exciting. Make up this great country of ours, Jeremy.
And finally, a very, very big thank you to the National Australia Day Council, the New South Wales Government, Destination New South Wales.